Angola, Lama Times, also known as Global Bazette, Umwanaka Shwapa Zambia. If you're new to my YouTube channel, please subscribe so that each time I upload videos, you will be notified, and make sure you press the bell so that you can get notifications.
Following the ritual activities that have been taking place in Zambia, some groups of people known as mobs have been taking the law into their own hands by searching for whom they suspect as being ritual killers or gassers and then taking their lives. A lot of people have lost family members. Some of my friends have lost their uncles, their aunties, their cousins. On Facebook, it's written all over. And the police have taken action. Here is a video by the inspector, the boss of the police of Zambia, as he states what he has to say.
Tendering an apology for having kept you this long. It was not intentional. We had the sanitarium somewhere. However, since you are here, we proceed with the program. Dear colleagues, members of the press, welcome to Police Service Headquarters for this update on the security situation in the country. We have called for this briefing so that through you, the media, we can update the nation on this matter of grave concern, both to the government as well as members of the general public. We could have given the extensive briefing much earlier, but for fear of jeopardizing investigations, we only release information cautiously at regular intervals. Now that we have made a lot of progress in investigations and affected arrests, we are able to interact with the public through you, the media. In doing so, let me start by providing the background to this matter. This current insecurity being experienced in the country emanated from criminal attacks in Chingora district of the Copperbelt province, in which three families were victims. As was indicated in the ministerial statement presented by Home Affairs Minister in Parliament, police on 29th August 2019 received the family of six in Chikora area of Chingora district were attacked by unknown criminals armed with machetes, in which four children aged between 4 and 12 years sustained serious injuries, while their mother was allegedly raped and murdered. The attackers used windows to gain entry and exit, and were targeting mainly the unfinished houses. The second attack occurred between the 15th of December 2019 21 hours on 16th December 2019 at 06 hours in Chikora Loop in Chingora, in which one male, Chanda Chama, aged 9 years, was attacked by criminals using suspected metal and sustained a painful left shoulder. The third occurrence happened between 29th December 2019 and 30th December 2019 at 8 hours in Chikora Loop in Chingora, in which Lepson Chongwe's family sustained a deep cut on the forehead, and Ruth Kampole, 22, his wife, also sustained a deep cut on her forehead and was strangled to death and raped. What a sad story. Emanating from these incidents, one suspect was apprehended by the public, who confessed that he was involved in the killings together with others whose names he mentioned. However, after investigations, the names mentioned were not connected to the occurrences. Further, the witch doctor was also named by concerned members of the public, but investigations revealed that he was not connected to the offense. The modus operandi in all these criminal acts was similar in that attackers targeted and finished houses and never stole anything after attacking. Further, the point of entry and exit from houses were windows. Riots started after a struggle to bury a body of one of the victims who was brutally killed and 29 rioters were apprehended. Afterwards, on Wednesday, 8th January 2020, between 8 hours and 19 hours, Chingola District experienced a series of riots in Chiwembala, Waiseni, Lulamba, and Chingola Townships. Consequently, the police apprehended a total of 158 suspects, among them 102 males and 21 females for rioters' behavior. These attacks where criminals could enter households and attack all members of the households brought insecurity and fear in the members of the public, and this sparked riots. As already mentioned, 158 suspects were charged with rioters behavior in Chingola. One other incident which sparked riots was a scenario where police officers from Russia went to Chiwembala, went to Chiwembala in Chingola to apprehend a suspect in a case of vandalism involving Zamtel cables. This suspect was later identified as a worker for a prominent businessman in the area. Members of the public immediately linked the businessman to the deaths that were experienced in the area and set his house and other properties on fire and subsequently looted shops in the area. During this period, videos and audios which were inciting in nature flooded social media, thereby raising fear and panic among members of the public. For instance, there were videos depicting events such as instant mob justice and murder which happened in other countries but were reported to be incidents of official murders happening in Zambia when they were not. Then the trend of chemical spraying emerged and spread to other towns of the Copper Belt, where some instances of public disorder were recorded and some public infrastructure, predominantly police infrastructure, among them Mabungo and Malaika police force in Russia, Wangwa in Kitwe, and Tenda police force in Chingola were destroyed. The crime trend then shifted from attacks on households where occupants were being hacked to malicious administering of poisonous chemical substance with intent to cause harm, being referred to by the public, you, the media, as gassing or chemical spraying. This began from Chiwembala in Chingola district. The instances of chemical spraying later spread to Northwestern province, where first reports were recorded in Nyama area and Lumwana East. This sparked riots in Kisasa area of Karumbira district, where a power tools bus and a Nissan hard body had windows smashed and occupants attacked by a mob. As a result of this disturbance, 35 people were apprehended for riotous behavior. Due to this public disorder, Kakaindu police post in Karumbira district and Kazambo police posts were guarded by mobs. However, police managed to quell all the instances of public disorder and have continued with investigations in the reports of alleged chemical spraying and malicious damage to public and private property. The same type of crime wave was experienced in Osaka early February 2020 with reports received from Osaka, Middle West. However, most of the initial reports were unverified as there were no visible effects on victims or chemical traces on the scene. Nonetheless, on 13th February 2020, suspected cases of chemical spraying were recorded in Chawama, Kanyama, John Howard, Chaisa, and Matero townships, where effects were evident on the victims. In reaction to these reports, members of the public took the law in their own hands and began attacking any person who they suspected not to be a member of their community. In some instances, mobs went to police stations where the assumed suspects in chemical spraying were detained and demanded for their release so that they could be lynched. As a result of this, four police infrastructure were damaged to Lemby, Chikwalo, Kanyama West, Mumba Road Police Force, and Kanyama Police Station, which is still under construction. Members of the public also blocked and damaged any motor vehicle spotted in their localities at night and assaulted their occupants. In most of such instances, victims were rescued by officers on patrol, while in some instances, victims ran to safety. Subsequently, instances of chemical spraying were experienced in other parts of the country, such as Eastern, Northern, Central and Southern provinces, while Wapula, Muchinga, and Western provinces had some reports which are still unverified. People killed in instant mob justice were a mere suspicion, especially in instances where a person involved may not be known in a particular community. In some instances, mental patients were victims of the instant mob justice. In Lusaka, most of the instances of mob justice were sparked off by illegal community security groupings on streets armed with an assortment of offensive weapons. The initiative by members of the public to equip themselves with whistles was with the aim of alerting other community members when attacked by criminals, which was a good initiative which worked well in Chingora. However, in Lusaka, the initiative was abused and led to innocent people being attacked by the public. Another trend emerged where members of the community began blocking some public roads and searching motor vehicles for suspected chemicals, which resulted in some motor vehicles being damaged. This conduct has instilled fear in the traveling public. One of this kind was the incident experienced in an area between Kafir Gorge Tanoff and Shamikobo village, in which 9 people were apprehended for riotous behavior and 2 were charged for being in possession of offensive weapons. Another incident was recorded in Chief Milambo of Mirenge district, in which civilian officers from Zambia National Service were victims of such attacks after they encountered a mob that had blocked the road, armed with all sorts of weapons, such as spears and axes. The mob further bent a motor vehicle, property of Zambia National Service. In addition to these ugly scenarios of mob justice, on 19 February 2020, police took a victim of mob justice to Matakoka Hospital for medical attention after suffering injuries. The mob reorganized themselves the following day and descended on the suspect, who they pulled out of the hospital and further beat him up and later sent the body to the place. What a shame. A similar incident happened in Zambia, where a mob damaged a community police post after police detained the suspect, who was handed over to police by some community members for loitering around 21-30 hours. The mob injured police officers who were manning the police post and managed to drag the suspect from the detention facility and bent him. This was just a sample of some of the encounters that police have had with mobs, and it is disturbing to note that people can even go to an extent of going to a health facility where people with different ailments are being attended to drag a patient from hospital and later kill merely on suspicion. After analyzing the scenarios involving mob justice and the mode of operation, we went further in our investigations to establish what could have been motivating the mobs to behave in that particular way. During investigations, it was established that there were groups of people formed and spread in various areas of the country, and that these groups were spearheading mob justice in communities. An operation was conducted on 20 February 2020 and apprehended 5 masterminders in this particular issue of mob justice, believed to have been influencing people in communities to kill and bend suspects. Among the suspects, 3 were picked for Kasisi area in Chongo, while 2 were picked in Osaka's Rema compound and have been all charged with murder, contrary to section 200 of the penal code. They are detained in custody and will appear in court soon. I'm warning all those that have not been arrested yet that their days are numbered and soon they will be behind bars. As a result of mob justice emanating from this, from false alarm, a total number of 43 people have died across the country, while 23 were injured. I'll repeat this. As a result of mob justice emanating from false alarm, a total number of 43 people have died across the country, while 23 were injured. It's indeed regrettable. Statistics further indicate that 511 reports connected to chemical spraying of poisonous substances on households have so far been received, with 1,687 victims. 11 police infrastructure have been damaged countrywide as a result of public disorder. Some of our motor vehicles have as well been damaged. Also damaged is the Serenje administration block for the local authority and the council guest house. Some private properties such as motor vehicles and guest houses have not been spared. 16 suspects have been arrested in connection with the reports of chemical spraying, of which some have begun appearing in courts of law. Some of these 16 suspects were behind criminal activities experienced in Chingola District on the Copper Belt, as well as Northwestern Province. This points to some interconnection in the criminals behind the spate of crimes. An investigation team comprising various stakeholders has been constituted to conduct investigations, and great progress has been recorded. The conclusive outcome of the investigations will be available to the public once investigations are concluded. With these developments, we are confident that instances of mob justice we have witnessed lately will now be under control. I wish to inform the public that the security situation in some parts of the country where there was public disorder, such as Lusaka, Copper Belt, and Northwestern provinces, has improved, in that the number of reports involving members of the public taking the law into their own hands have reduced. Also reduced are reports of chemical spraying in households. However, officers from defense and other security wings are on alert and still monitoring the situation. Suffice to mention that there are still security concerns in other parts of the country, such as Wafula, Southern and Western provinces, where instances of public disorder are still being recorded. I therefore call upon members of the public to desist from these acts of mob justice, because anyone found wanting will be dealt with in accordance with the law. Allow me now to reiterate our warning to all those who are in the habit of abusing social media for hate speech and to cause hate speech and to alarm and cause fear in the country. We have warned before that days of such characters are numbered. In this regard, I wish to report that police in Chingola have arrested Mubanga Elizabeth Chiba, the wife of a musician, and charged her for the offense of seditious publication with intent to cause fear and alarm. The suspect was traced to be behind the audio that went viral on social media claiming that Mulonga Water and Sewerage Company on the Copper Belt was contaminated with chemicals, and called on people not to consume water from this utility. She was released on police bond and will appear in court soon. Another suspect, identified as Jimmy Wembia, aged 23, was apprehended by the police in connection with the circulation of the video depicting murder that happened in another country, deceiving people that it happened in Chingola. Investigations pointed to this suspect, who later was picked up from Solwezi. And further investigations revealed that he was also behind one of the deaths recorded in Chingola and was on the run when the four other suspects were cornered. He has since been charged with murder, attempted murder, and rape. I want to conclude by assuring the country not to panic because the situation is under control. All the security wings are together working day and night to protect our communities. Further, let me seize this opportunity to thank all the patriotic Zambians who have been cooperating with us by giving us various leads which have led to these arrests so far. This should send a strong warning to those who still would want to engage themselves in criminal activities that there is no hiding place for them. And those abusing social media for hate speech, to insult and malign innocent people, and indeed to cause fear and alarm in the nation, I can only promise that we are coming for you. The arrest of Muvanga Elizabeth Chira and Jimmy Wembia is a clear demonstration that there is no hiding place in the cyberspace. We are on top of things. The Zambia Police Service and ZICTA are working on all these cases, and many people will soon be brought to book. I wish also to warn members of the public who are claiming to have information about happenings in the country to avoid going to the public, as this is also causing fear in people. But they should instead send in their information to the police for appropriate action to be taken. We have made attempts by inviting some of them, but no one has come forth. I'm therefore, through you, the media, extending another invitation to people who would have information to come through and avail such information. I wish to inform you that we will continue providing updates every after 2 days to avoid speculation and misinformation. The way forward, security measures on prevailing security situation, including schools and other public institutions. We are enhancing capacity of the scenes of crime management by provision of necessary logistics for effective evidence collection. We are using our public relations office through robust sensitization programs to members of the public. Some of you colleagues have been assisting us with this, which we totally appreciate. We have also put up 2 investigative teams. One team which is focusing on analyzing gassing incidents, and the other which is focused on public order management of riotous incidences. We also have deployed officers on the ground to collect human intelligence in the crime-prone, densely populated areas. We have intensified foot and motorized patrols in densely populated townships and compounds with such criminal activities and where it's so prevalent. We have also enhanced collaboration between members of the public through the community policing units, the CCPUs, and the Zambia Police Service. Collaboration has also been extended to local government authorities in the enforcement of bylaws in order to control the movements of people and trading hours. With regard to the security situation on schools and other learning institutions, I'm urging school management authorities to create security committees as well as install security cameras so that we look out for people loitering within their vicinities. These are the measures we've put in place. I wish to conclude from here, but before I conclude, let me just add one item which has just come up. We have seen that there is a report in the Daily Mail headlined Masterminders arrested. A Zambia police would like to clarify that the headline in today's Daily Mail, that the person who was arrested among the 16 suspects as a founder, that our investigations have revealed that this person through whom funds were channeled to pay those who were arrested is not a mastermind. So it's part of those 16 who have been held. It's not a mastermind. So please quote it correctly. It's not a mastermind. Are we together? Yes. So this is the position of the Zambia Police Service, that this headline is misleading. The mastermind hasn't been nabbed. With that, I wish to conclude the briefing. But before we come to the question, I know you are itching to cut off the IG's head. Mm-hmm. I have the PS information with me here, who will have a chat with you, the members of the press. I thank you all.
Thank you, IG. I thank you for that extensive report. Mine is just a short intervention, just to appeal to you colleagues in the media during this period, just to appeal that you exercise a lot of caution as you go about the reporting, particularly on this subject. As you know, as the media, you are a very powerful tool to influence public opinion, and so you help to set the agenda. Every morning when you wake up, there are various discussions, and this has been a topical issue for the last few weeks. And the way we discuss, we can alarm the situation, or we can help to calm down the emotion in the country. You know that she has been speak today. We have about 142 radio stations countrywide, and 46 TV stations. So you can see that people's access to media or information has been very enhanced in the last 2 years, which is a good thing. But again, if we don't guard against some of the excesses, we may find that as the media, we could play a role in either worsening the situation or coming down. So my appeal to you colleagues is to see how you can exercise patriotism and set the tone for debate on this matter, so that we help to calm down the emotions and we don't contribute to alarm the situations. As you have seen, in some cases, like the IG has reported, in some cases, people have alarmed the situation and they just actually did not. Other people who are acting, they are acting based on what they are learning from either mainstream media or social media. So for me, my plea to you colleagues in the media is just to plead that during this period, and as we report on this subject, you exercise a lot of caution so that you help to calm down the emotion, the nerves, and indeed you avoid inciting the situation so that people now start getting involved in acts that border on criminality or instant mobs. So I thought I could just make that appeal to you, please. Thank you very much.
Thank you, the PS. I hope the media got the message clearly. Assist us to put on the situation in the country by avoiding inciting members of the public. Because the more you give out information which is causing fear in the people, this situation will continue. Please assist us to contain the situation by being sensitive and reporting correctly. Thank you.
From the media, it's now time to take questions. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'll proceed to answer the three questions. I'll begin with the one from Pamela. Looking at the prevailing situation in the country now, this should not only go to church gatherings, just to all members of the public. We should take precautions not to hold unnecessary gatherings in the night or undertake movements when it's late. You will be a victim of this mob justice. So my advice to the church is to avoid these overnight gatherings as it is now until the situation returns to normal. Gloria from Vine TV, is it a crime? Yes, it can be a crime after the information is tested. But if it's just speculation, I think it cannot be taken seriously. That's why we're inviting these people to come to give it the evidence. But after we find that the information that are withholding are beneficial to the investigations, then people will be charged with withholding information. So I'm urging people with information to come forward and give the information to the police that will assist with the investigation. So if you have information, please come. Even now, we'll deal with it. Otherwise, we'll charge you once we discover that you have evidence which you are withholding. Diamond TV, type of the chemical. I hope you colleagues, members of the press, you are following these matters closely. Only yesterday, we had this matter before court. I believe you are aware that we had people who appeared in court. Those chemicals were spelled out in the indictment. So please follow with the courts in Chingola. You'll see what type of chemical we are talking about. Then, the motive, we have discovered that is to instill fear in people. This is which is giving rise to this mob justice. You instill fear in people and they feel insecure. So as they intend to defend themselves, they are causing these deaths. So the motive is to instill fear and cause instability in the country. That's the motive of this gas.
One, two, three.
Good morning.
Just one question for one each. So pick out the most important question if you are still at school.
morning, Angie. I am Jimmy Kanasha from CBC Television. Looking at the list of victims that have been enlisted, the majority are women. So I'd like to find out why. What's the motive? The number of victims is more on the women's side.
Victims of
gassing, mainly. So I'd like to find out that, what's the motive.
The victims of gassing.
Yes, most gassing victims.
When these people got to attack you, they spray a chemical substance in your home, then most women are getting affected.
Yes.
Don't you think that's for medical
experts? I'm not sure.
That one is answered. We are subjecting the patients to the hospitals and medical examinations are being conducted. So we are certain once we receive these results from the medical authorities. Next question.
I'm Virginia from Movie TV. I don't know, in your speech you indicated that 43 people have died and 23 are injured as a cause of no justice. I don't know, maybe you haven't indicated those that were shot. And then also, I want to find out about the Chingola man that was shot in the chemicals that were taken from him for that.
Since you have given me three questions, I'll answer before I forget. I'll start with the chemicals. I'll refer you back to her question. Follow the news. I believe you people in the media are on top of things as regards to news. That matter is the matter I'm referring to. The person appeared before court. So the chemicals are listed out in there.
The one in Chibola died. The one in Chibola died.
Okay, yes, I was trying to. Yes, the chemicals have been examined and results are positive. What was that? The number of people shot by the police are included in the 43 people. I'm being guided that we have not compiled this, but I'll refer you to the law. If you go to section 78 of the Penal Code, I believe all of you have got books on law. As you report, you should look at the law, what it says. The police are protected by law that if upon expiration of reasonable time, after such a proclamation has been made, where 12 or more persons continue righteous assembly together, any person authorized or a police officer may do all things necessary to disperse the persons so continuing with the assembly. So the police are empowered to use force in dealing with these riotous crowds. You've heard the police saying you cannot go with the Bible when people are throwing stones and all these other things. That's why we are issued with these firearms and we work within the confines of the law. So you can read further on section 78 of the Penal Code, because I couldn't go into details of how this is done. But a police officer shall not be held liable for any injury or death caused during such a process. So please take note of that. Is that clear? Read the Penal Code. Again, going further, section 24 of the Zambia Police Act gives guidelines on how firearms are used. So police use these firearms according to the mandate.
Section 78. 78. You know about it. So for the statistics, we may release in later on. Because immediately when we say two people, one person, the stray bullet and the leg, you, the same media, may end up now. It's a very dangerous situation, and we look at the current situation on the ground. We would not want to have such an instance.
It will be police have killed 43 people. Now you will be alarming the situation.
So it's true, Mom.
So please read the section 78, then you understand. Police are authorized.
One, there. I think after this we'll get two.
Let's go, we can be here the whole day.
Okay.
Interact. I know you're reaching.
Yes.
But I hope after this you go back and participate in the sensitization so that we are on the same page. You, the next time we meet, we give you an update, we go out to inform public accordingly.
Yes, we can have you. Yes.
Good morning, my name is Noel Yombo from Daily Nation. Mine is a concern and a question at the same time. Apex University is about to send students for outreach in rural areas. What would be your advice to the institution?
Through you, please, since you know, go and tell them that this is no time for such activities. They have to suspend. You have seen it in China, the coronavirus. They have suspended all lessons. So I think in this scenario, we also need to look at these issues from that angle. This is not time for that. You've seen Minister of Health, they have suspended the activities they were doing. So let them learn from what is happening.
Good morning, IJ.
Morning, are you inviting me for tea?
Yeah, we could talk afterwards. It's a follow-up question on the people that have indicated that they have information about who the masterminds are, who the gassers are. You said you have invited them as police, but then they haven't come. What happens if they don't come? Can't police, you know, sort of force them to come and give the information so that the people are caught?
As a peace-loving police service, we will keep engaging them. But once we find that it's out of speculation, they'll be charged because they have caused the alarm already. So they should take note that their utterances has caused the alarm. They should come forth and assist the police to arrive at what is happening.
Would there be a duration?
No. We'll act as quick as possible. Because we can't keep on hanging on to such information. No. We need to move and they must move fast.
IG, my name is Chris. I write for you. Just explain to us what how this problem started and what you're doing about it. What else would you like to say to members of the public out there who are saying this is not coming as Chris is coming?
Thank you very much. That's a good one. You know, without police, you people would not have even been here. We have not even managed to come to police headquarters. So I would urge all members of the public to have confidence in the police. Just like Salim was saying, what are we going to do? They have to be patriotic. Let them bring that information. That information will assist us and instill stability in the country. So I will only urge members of the public to have confidence in the police. We are here as per mandate to maintain law and order. I tell you, if today we say, oh, we'll take off uniforms, please, free for all, oh, you leave this country. So people must not resort to fighting the police. Let them work hand in hand with the police. Because together, we'll fight this crime. That's the message to the members of the public. Let's put our heads together and work.
Saying
that this
task is too complex for the police and
that
they need the officers out there?
Not at all. I wish to tell you that this is not a sign of failure. I took this action to avoid further bloodshed. We needed to move in fast to contain the situation. It's not that police have failed, no. That's why there's the Defense Force Act. We work together in times as such. So it's not a sign of failure. We wanted to avert a further bloodshed. It was being proactive than waiting for it to reach neck. Then that's when we said, no. That's why I thought it wise that we nip in the bud before it gets out of hand. And the president gladly allowed us to work together. And you've seen the collaboration. It's fantastic.
And then photograph in the canali. I've been drafted by special engineer officers during your course of our work. Those are junior officers, they are not aware that you have to work here, I'm not trying to refute. I've seen the senior officers being asked to ask back to junior officers. That's been tough. Again, by the issue of producing the fake photograph to pay to the current number plate. Sometimes that is that it's the same, personalized.
Thank you very much. On the behavior of the junior officers, I need to implore them that you, the colleagues, the major, we need to work together. But if you identify yourself, I don't think the reasonable officer will push you around. They will gladly work with you. As long as you are cooperative and I don't think, unless they see that maybe your intentions are not in support of what is happening. You just want to be against what is happening. Yes, they will push you aside. Then on vehicles not being registered, there are laws here in Zambia which fall under the Road Traffic Act. There have been instances where vehicles have been impounded, and so I would urge people to follow the procedure to avoid being inconvenienced. Because what will happen will be that the people will be bounded and pass through a lot of these inconveniences. So we advise people, even just for their safety. Because if a vehicle is not registered, it's stolen. How do you find it? That's around the corner. Put there the comma one. And you won't find it. So we'll get people to follow the rules and regulations as the Road Traffic Act. Okay, two questions related to one. This is the NGO and what we're doing there. This is a matter which is being investigated. But I'll tell you one sad story about this incident. On that particular day, you know, it was a rainy day here in Lusaka. Around 7:15 there about. You know, at times I also drive on my own. I don't even inform, I go around just to see what is happening. I saw a call consistently on my phone. What should be this? Then I answered, oh, this is Aguyu. I'm being killed here, the noise behind there. Where are you? They said, no, I'm in Gwembe. So they already bent my car, now they want to, oh, I said, oh my God, what is this? Then I called the commissioner. Please, commissioner, people are being killed in Gwembe. Send officers there. Gosh. Sadly, 10 minutes after I received a call, Natty has been killed. I feel hurt. I'm sure that this matter is thoroughly investigated. Those allegations, they are talking about what was found with him. The syringes, I know that Mr. Hakuyu is, Hakuyu is diabetic. But anyway, we have subjected them to laboratory tests. But I know the syringe was used for this diabetic situation. Otherwise, we are investigating that matter. I think now I'm tired. I'm becoming emotional now. What was this question you asked? I talked to that person minutes before he died.
That's
how sad. I could hear people breaking that the room where he was. I'm being killed here. Oh, my God.
Next question. Yes, yourself.
I wish I had.
No, on that one, not about the last questions.
Okay, I'm Moenwa from Millennium Radio.
Millennium.
Yes. I don't know if it's just my observation, but I think in terms of the patrols by the police, they're a bit selective. Certain parts of Lusaka, I've hardly seen patrols from either the army or the police, and I think it should spread across. Because for me, I for one, in my area, I've not seen any single officer. That's waterworks, as you go towards Chalala, I'm not
seeing I wish to assure you that Lusaka has been divided in zones. Everywhere, officers are around, working hand in hand with the army. Maybe the time they are around, even this in the day, they are patrolling in all these areas. So I think you are saying, you know, it does not. They are all over. Unless you want me to be a guard at your place, I'm glad you do that. The other one.
Good morning, Aiken. My name is Shashi. I'd like to get an update of the two named police officers, senior police officers from Corbett.
Okay, I will clear the air on this. People are trying to connect the action you've taken against the officers to the gassing. That is not correct. The action we have taken against the officers is the omission. They failed to perform their duties according to what they're supposed to do. That's why they are being charged. It's not that they are part of the people gassing, no. That is the position. They should not connect these two matters. This other one is administrative. Why we are charging those officers? They failed to perform their duties. That's how serious we are looking at this matter. So people should not trivialize these cases. That's why our own officers are being punished.
Last question. Yes.
My name is Vincent from Malaysia. What was the impact of the news of Pakistan? Is that they are going to buy hiding the name of that way to work together?
You know, you heard it in Parliament. The vice president was telling you, there are processes in all what we do. It's not just like stand up and because I'm IG, we can do. No. I'm also guided by processes. If we are just gotten to, oh no, this is that, when the matter goes to court, they'll say you already exposed them. That's why the evidence will come out in court. Where now the experts will stand and give evidence to the effect that, oh, this, I did this examination, this chemical results to, you people did the chemistry. Then you will be able to know. Yes, yes.
I think that is the point I was trying to make. When I was saying, let's be cautious the way we report, we can help to calm down the situation or to alarm the situation. Because when you start pushing in that line of the person, then people start now debating and start asking questions. What is it that the police are doing? Are they making it worse or are they? So I think we also have to ensure that the police, we give them enough latitude. We don't want when they go to court, then they lose cases. And then you start saying, look, they did a bad job. So there are certain things that can be said before the matter goes in court, and certain things that cannot be said. So I think what is important is maybe regular interaction, and I think Madam Takamba has been very open. We can try even have some off-the-record discussion so that we can just have a clear picture, and then we help, because we are the ones who are talking to the public. And then the public will be acting or reacting depending on what we are saying as the media. That is why, as a media, like I said, we are very powerful. And we set the agenda for discussion. So let's be cautious that the way we act the report, we don't help in alarming the situation. Because people are helpless now. And this time everyone is tuned to the radio, TV, just trying to get the information. So the information they get will now inform them, and they will react according to the information that they have received.
Thank you very much, sir, for finding time to talk. colleagues. I think this has been the time that you have always been waiting for, and it has come to pass. So, as the public relations office, we'll continue giving you updates on the new developments. I think the Inspector General of Police gave a background of how this whole thing started. Remember to do that, because even when it was given in Parliament, so he remembered to go back to that, so that he gives you the background of this board issue. So it's now up to you, as the PS has said, that you help us now in sensitizing members of the public, or giving information based on what the Inspector General of Police has said. This is our role to ensure that this whole insecurity, and we shouldn't always be looking at breaking news. How many of they killed? How many of they killed? I think with those that we had charged on our blog there, I asked the question, I think Sabine saw that, to say, what role are you playing in the media? Do we just want to report how many people have been killed? Why are we not talking much on the people that are involved in the instant mob justice? So that we condemn that as the media. Through that, people will be able to know, to say that this is an issue which is not supposed to be as it is now. But thank you very much, sir. And I'll request, sir, for your express permission for me from here to switch off my phone, so that I just have time to rest.
No, you need to continue. You need to continue. That's why you're there.
Thank you. Thanks for watching my YouTube channel. It's a girl Lelama Tams, also known as Galopa Zed. If you enjoy more of my stories, stay tuned to my YouTube channel.